Hello again, folks. Welcome back to the next episode of Joxa Playing Skyrim, the Argonian Assassin. In the previous episode, you saw me hitting 100 in blacksmithing, and I'm ready to craft my armor now. I have no idea how the dragonbone went all the way from the road to here when I loaded the game. But anyways, look who's back! It's Serana! I used the console to summon her. Apparently I left her somewhere and I have no idea where. She's been good while I was doing my smithing. She took care of a few problems that were sneaking up on me. Anyways, let's have a little looky. I took the liberty of just grabbing everything that I needed. I am using Shadowplay today because apparently they fixed it. With the Dolby 5.1 you can hear all the channels now, so here's hoping it actually works because I really like the whole Shadowplay. Anyways, Dragonbone Dagger. Pretty obvious, yeah, that's a yes. Okay, now is the second one, and this is a little bit of a hard one to choose. Do I want a sword, or do I want a war axe? That's a difficult question, actually, because the war axe does a little bit more damage than the sword, but I think the sword has a longer reach. I'll pick both. I can get an ebony ingot from just melting my dagger that I currently have, Ognum's dagger. And we'll give it a try. For now, I'll make the Dragonbone Sword. There you go. Let's have a looky. We have the Dragon Scale. There you go. That's the Dragon Scale Armor. The Boots. The Gauntlets. The Helmets. I'm not gonna go for the shield. All the other ones that you can see, the Dragon Steel stuff, that's from one of my mods. And for some reason, the mod maker made everything underpowered. I don't know why, because some of this stuff looks really, really awesome, but it's way weaker. I'm not interested in it. It's like super weak. One thing I noticed is, like the bow here. Can we see the bow? Thank you. It looks really simplistic though in the creation. I kind of expected a little bit more from it. Anyways, that's my Dragon Skill armor. Let's put it on and see how it looks. If it ever, there you go. I kinda like how it looks with my horns. That looks kinda wicked. Yeah, I can get used to this. What do you guys think? Yes to the helmet or no? Let me know in the comments below. If you say no, I will just go and grab that circlet that I can create and use it. Actually, let's just go and create a circlet because it doesn't use anything important other than dragon skills, and I think I have like a ton of dragon skills just laying around. There you go, Dragon Skill Circlets. Okay, let's have a looky. And Dragon Skill Circlets, there you go. So it's either this or the helmet. I kind of personally like the helmet. It looks a little bit more menacing and fitting for the armor. There you go. Kind of like it. I'm digging it. This looks cool. Let's check out the weapons that I got from this. Dragon Bone Dagger and the Dragon Bone Sword. The sword looks a little bit large, doesn't it? Well, it's not too bad. It's not too bad at all. So what do you guys think? Does this look fitting or not? I'm not sure. The dagger looks okay. I'm not sure about the sword. The sword might be a little bit too big. I don't know. Let me know in the comments below as well, and I will, as always, listen to what you guys say and possibly make changes. It's a little bit weird for me playing at the moment because I am playing in full screen mode. Yes, in Shadowplay I can do full screen without losing a single FPS. That's why I absolutely love Shadowplay at the moment. Anyways, my horse is here somewhere, I think. He ran off again. Anyways, we've got this all created. I should probably go and melt down my dagger, shouldn't I? Yeah. There you go. Use the melter. Ebony ingot for Ognum's dagger. I'll do that. Yoink. And instead of the war axe, I'll just go and create my bow, because one of you guys actually said in one of my videos, if you use a higher quality bow, you have more chance to actually get a level up. And you know, that's an interesting point. If that is true, then oh yeah, I'm all game for that. There you go. Created the dragon bow bone. Now we're gonna actually see how we can upgrade everything. I need dragon bone, dragon bone, dragon bone. That's gonna be easy because I have so many dragon bones that I have unused. And for the armor, scale, 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 and scale. Okay, that's gonna be easy for me. Because I have some stuff laying around. Let's see, smithing, dwarven bracers, and smith. There you go, blacksmith's potion. Let's just do it right now. I mean, we're standing here anyways. Legendary, folks. Legendary. And, like, right away we're gonna do the weapons. And done and done. It was pretty easy, if I have to say so myself. I expected this to be a little bit harder, but nope. Okay, this can be unfavorited. I'm letting you guys just enjoy me derping around in the game a little bit. Oh, another quick announcement. As of next week, or at least the end of January a little bit, I will start going full force again with my updates and stuff. I think I've left YouTube alone for enough time now. For those of you wondering what was going on, basically YouTube added a new system. And this system actually changed a few things around in how IDs worked. And there were like really weird stuff happening. Like, I know of a person who had over 50 ID claims from just doing Blizzard games like World of Warcraft, Hearthstone, etc. And their channel was getting close to being shut down. And the problem here is Blizzard has like this blanket statement, that's what it's called in legal terms. Basically it's on their website, and they say that everybody can do a YouTube movie of Blizzard games and monetize, put ads on them, without problems, as long as Blizzard hold the rights. And YouTube just went like, hey, no, that's all Blizzard property, you can't have those videos. And they took down everything. So the system isn't working completely properly yet, but I think after a month, well, it's more like a month and a half, they kind of fixed everything. So that's it. Anyways, folks, I'm gonna go and grab Horsey, put everything in the Horsey, and have a look at enchanting and alchemy. So folks, 1 second. And here we are again. I quickly checked out my house, and apparently I did not create a enchanting tower. I completely forgot that most of my house was created with alchemy in mind. So yeah, I'm not sure if I actually had created a second house or not. We'll check it out in a second, but for now, there you go. It's always a little bit finicky trying to get your thingy going, but we got this. Restore stamina, yes. Can I like just mess around with something? Okay. Restore health. Restore health. And it doesn't say what this does. Restore stamina, restore health. What does that do? Let's see. 45 health? Really? Okay, let's see this one. Restore health. Let's have a looky then. This one. But I kind of expected something extra from adding this. I don't get it. Yeah, quit alchemy. I want to see my stuff now, because I'm a little bit confused now. Alchemy. Restore health. Fortify health. Hmm. So So that's kind of a waste then, putting those others in there. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay, well, whatever. It works, right? There you go. Making a whole bunch of these bad boys. There you go. Yes, quit alchemy. I'm not sure if these guys actually will make a dent. It's only 39, but you know what? I have a ton of them with me, so I should be able to get myself up if you know it's needed. And I have a lot of ingredients, like, you know, from just traveling, so that's no biggie. There we go. Now the other thing I wanted to do was enchanting, and we do not have an enchanting table here. Uh-oh. So yeah, I think this was a... What was this again? Miscellaneous. I have no idea what this is. Oh, it's a display room. Okay. Yeah, that is for my armor and stuff. Fair deals. But I do need to enchant this armor if I want to continue on, which is a little bit of a problem, because, you know, I can't walk around with an armor without any proper enchantments. Yeah. Okay. Had a little bit of a crash there. I hope you guys completely didn't notice that. I'll be editing it out, or at least try to editing out. And take it from there. Anyways, we have a small problem, which is the fact that I do not have an enchanting tower, which I thought I had. Derp! But it's absolutely no problem. I mean, let's have a look quick. We have a white run. Well, we have this house, that's obvious. We don't have this house. Eh. And we don't have this house, so we definitely do not have the three, the big three. Which is okay. I want to get myself the solitude house, for sure. One of you guys told me that apparently there's a stone of Baron Zaya in there. Which I do want. I want to create this crown type thing. And I also am tempted to go and get the house in Whiterun, just cuz. I know, that sounds weird, but just cuz. Anyways, just waiting until Serana properly follows me. Are you following me? Come. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, there you go. Okay, and we're fast traveling to a white run. I'm just gonna go straight to Dragon's Reach. And here we are again. What are we supposed to do here?
Huh?
I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. There's apparently a quest here. The Jarl's Justice. Numbers job. Dark Brotherhood forever. Why do I need to go to Aventus? Oh, hey, Aventus!
I serve Jarl Balgra, steward.
The giant is dead?
Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
Thank you. Oh, all of 100, man. Whoa! Thank you so much.
Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
Anyways, we were looking at doing some enchanting. Let's see, disenchant. I took some stuff with me here. Iron Sword of Burning, I really don't care, so yoink. Ta-da. And Mage Illusion, yups. I'm not, don't want to do that one, nope. Necklace of Dwindling Fire. Minus stamina, yep. Rejuvenation, yes. Necklace of Resist Fire. I think I already had it, didn't I? There you go. One Ring of Extreme Health. No, I can do that with a minor health. There you go. It's the miners that I'm after, really. Minor sneaking, hell yeah. There you go. No, 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 not too fast. Ring of Replenishing, yes. Okie dokie, and... I already had her, that one. One-handed attacks do 20% more damage. Nope, we're gonna go and finish this first. Do I want to... Nah, not yet. I'm scared to use this one. It's such a good ring. Anyways, enchantment. Item. I want my dragon scale. Gauntlet is the most important one. Enchantment should be backstab. And I'll use the smallest soul gem for that. There you go. Double sneak attack damage. Craft. No, I can rename it first. Sneaky dragon skill. Now, if I do it like that, it doesn't come up correctly in the search. So back stab. There you go. And craft. Yes. Look at that. Beautiful. Then I have my helmet. Helmet. Enchantment, that should be a fortify archery, definitely 15% more magic damage or bow damage, definitely a big one. So rename item, and we'll rename that with of archery. There you go, looks very authentic. Yes. And lastly, another important one is the muffle enchantment. Muffle, there you go. Soul gem, just a little one. But a muffle is a muffle. Whoa, there you go. Where is muffled? Rename item. Of sneakiness. There you go. And craft. Item, anything else that I can really do? The armor itself, yes. And what enchantment can I put on it? Health per 20. Let's first put in a Grand Soul Gem. I can stamina regeneration, stamina 21st health. It's kind of stamina regenerates 12 if I choose a greater. 8%. That's not a whole lot, to be honest. I'm not gonna do it. That's just a waste of a good like slot that I can use. So we're just gonna keep it like this for now, and we have our standard set ready to go again. I'm quite pleased thus far. It we got our armor done, we got our sneakiness done, we do more bow damage, we have muffle, and we have of course the new armor all ready to go. And thus far I haven't had a lot of FPS troubles. Anyways folks, sorry if this has been a little bit of a longish episode of me crafting and stuff, but you know, it's important points in the game in my personal opinion, because you know, it's the points where I'm basically powering up, I'm getting better, I'm getting stronger and ready to take on the world. So folks, oh lord, just shut up Farangar. Anyways, as I was trying to say before Farangar interrupted me, let me know in the comments below if you like the sword or you think I should give the War Axe a try, and what you think of the helmet. I personally am positive about the helmet. I kind of like it. It fits nicely with the horns. Looks a little bit, you know, I don't know, it has a certain look. Anyways, folks, that's going to be the end of the episode. Again, thanks for watching, and as always, I'll be right back.